New Jersey respects
Barack. You got out for
New Jersey respects Barack Obama. We like his style. We like what he stands for.
We like what he stands for.
Change will never come on the wheels of inevitability. We have to fight, scratch, knock on doors, pull, push, and do whatever we have to do until we can make change.
This isn't just about getting Barack Obama elected. It's about changing politics. It's about changing our communities. Because that's where it really is. If you really think about what quote-unquote politics is, it's communities. And it's being involved in your communities, because every political decision is a decision. There is an individual behind each choice that is made that affects the government, that affects your lives. So what we've been doing is we're trying to bring in new people into that decision-making process.
We can determine what this country is going to be about and where we're going to be. So that is who you are today. Take that power and take that message of hope. Take it to the community, but also keep in mind that you need to listen to what the community is saying, because we need to know. Barack needs to know.
Sometimes is a little bit squeamish for people, but power is a good thing. All right? Powerlessness is bad.
Making the decisions. Then you find out where the information is. Then you find out when they're having the meeting. And when you start to have that information, there's a great thing that happens. You become powerful. You become powerful within your community.
Right now, we're at a rally for Barack Obama in Newark, New Jersey. We're here to show our support. We're here to motivate people to go register, to go vote, and to make history.
That Obama is touching people that had given up faith, who had given up hope, who become cynical, who had just thought that politics was politics as usual, and we did not have a chance. Suddenly, for the first time in years and years and years, we have somebody that is making us believe again. That our country can be a country for everyone, from those who are magnified by the media to those who are marginalized, from those who have been left behind to those who are enjoying individual success.
We have a candidate that not only inspires us, but inspires our children, inspires us not only because of what our race is, but inspires us because he reaches our humanity, and we know what he says is actually the truth.
Nelson Mandela once said that. He said, our greatest fear is not that we're inadequate, our greatest fear is that we're powerful beyond belief.
Black mama, mama's on, wait, mama's for Obama, there you go. Somebody stole my Obama, hey, From where?
Somebody stole my Obama sign from my lawn.
What?
Yes. I had a sign.
Right,
did you see
right,
it?
Right,
in the middle of the lawn, about 2 days. Come back.
Somebody took it.
They walked on my lawn. That's bold.
You
know
who
did it.
Yeah. You know who did it.
So I got one and I got texted to the house.
Right.
I dared him to take it off the house.
Off the house, right.
Right.
I think he's an inspirational, charismatic candidate. I think he's the answer, and I think he'll make a great president.
Once in a generation, someone will appear on the scene who thinks differently, who sees the world differently, with a much clearer perspective than anybody else on the scene. And that's him.
I'm here volunteering because I feel I need to give any time that I can to help Barack Obama. And if I can make phone calls, if I can send out literature, whatever little part I can play, I think is my duty and responsibility.
May I feel your arms around me. May I feel your blood mixed with mine. The dream of life comes to me like a catfish dancing on the end of my line. Sky of blackness and sorrow. Sky of love, sky of tears, sky of glory and sadness, sky of mercy, sky of fear, sky of memory and shadow. Your burning wind fills my arms tonight. Sky of longing and emptiness, sky of fullness, sky of blessed light.
First they ignore you.
Then you win.